Welcome to the Efficient Kitchen, the first episode of all time, could be the last, depending on how it goes. I'm your host, Flavor Phrase. I know the name's a little bit terrible, but maybe you'll start Googling and be like, oh, what was that amazing, you know, cooking show? Flavor Phrase. Bang. SEO in a nutshell, baby. So today we're cooking homemade chicken noodle soup from scratch. We're gonna do it a bit of the hard way. However, my recipe online and here, I'll give you tips to kind of do it the quick way. I know it sounds great to maybe just, you know, open up a can, toss in the microwave, boom, you've got your chicken noodle soup. Because one, if you're making it, you're probably sick, tired, it's cold outside, you don't want to do anything. Or maybe it's a bit of a date night. This is date night wizardry. I'm gonna start cutting up some stuff here and talk you through it. But I've got all the fixins we can make for this chicken noodle soup. So you know, you get the date night, you're excited for it. And what happens? You get a text, let's say around 2 p.m. Oh, sorry, you know, I'm feeling under the weather, can we rain check? And maybe it's like a new thing, a new little fling. And you're like, oh no, like, what do I do? What do I say? She's feeling too sick. You know, I just don't want you to see me like this. You come across with the, no, honey, no. You know, if I can't see you at your worst, then I don't deserve you at your best. What we have here is the onions, basil leaves, garlic, a little bit of lemon juice, carrots, celery, and then over there we've got the egg noodles, everything you need on that end. Actually lost my peeler, which sounds extremely dumb. So if you don't have a peeler for your carrots, not too hard. Get one of these little bad boy little knife, shave it off like that. Simple enough. See, right? You're kind of taking me seriously now. You're like, oh wow, you just peel them with a knife? You don't want them too thick and you don't want them too thin. So just kind of trying to find that nice little medium. Dogs can eat carrots. So feel free to, you know, let them clean up a couple carrots. Those are fine. It's one thing we'll have throughout the show is what can dogs eat? Dogs can eat carrots. All right, so we're all ready. Everything's diced up. We're gonna start cooking things up. Get the vegetables a little soft. 2 tablespoons of oil. Onions, I'm gonna toss some onions in there. This is already hot. Let's go on. Throw on the rest of the vegetables. Oh. So we stirred that around. It's been about, you know, 3 minutes. We can probably get our garlic in there now. Toss in garlic. This is about 2 tablespoons, 3 tablespoons. I don't want all of it. I mean, I probably do. I love garlic. And it's great for when you're sick. So, I mean, garlic's everyone's friend. And I'm gonna toss in a little bit of lemon juice just for a touch of flavor. You can add in more later. That's probably about 1 teaspoon. Now we're gonna add in that chicken broth. I just added in 1 box. You can get it from Sprouts, Trader Joe's for less than $2. You can really get it anywhere. I got low sodium broth because you can always add salt, you can't take it away. So I'm gonna try it with the low sodium salt. If I feel like, you know, it still needs a little bit more salt or seasoning, I'll add that later. But already the onions and everything else in here smell so good that the ideal world is all the garlic and vegetables you've put in. They give it all that kind of flavor you need without, you know, adding extra sodium and such to your diet. So we're gonna pour this whole box in, get it in there, and you're gonna let that go for about 10 more minutes. So what do you do for 10 minutes? You prep other stuff. I've got the egg noodles here. I use egg noodles. Everyone kind of uses egg noodles for chicken noodle soup, CNS, we call it in the biz. Yeah, just because they're light and they're really easy. You can obviously go with something healthier as well, but that's kind of the generic thing to use. So we're waiting on that. Everything's looking good. Maybe turn my heat up a little more. Drinking wine? Yeah, I mean, you have to drink wine and cook, right? And it's a Sauvignon Blanc from New Zealand, so it's full of citrus, which I think fights you being sick if you're cooking it because you're sick. White wine, though, from a large red wine glass. I know some of you are judging me. I'm gonna live my life how I wanna live it, so whatever. So you're gonna get that to a medium boil, then we're gonna add in the chicken. You also wanna add in like a tablespoon of your own spice if you want, so you can do like an oregano basil combo or just vegetable, which kind of combines them all. So I'm gonna kind of do that in my hand. Give that a whirl. Salt and pepper to taste. I know I'm a fraud. I've got the pug ones here and I don't have stuff in them. They're just for decoration. Now, very important is you wanna test and make sure that your soup has enough seasoning now and it tastes good now, because once you add in the raw chicken, it's really no going back from there. So this is where you wanna be like, all right, is this gonna be good? Now it's boiling. It's boiling. Let me bring that down to a simmer. So we're gonna try it out. To be honest, I could use a good chunk more of seasoning, so we're gonna add in some more vegetable, some more salt. Not much salt comes out of this one. We might have to change the pugs. You can't go wrong with Mrs. Dash in anything, so I'm gonna season up a little Mrs. Dash. Whenever I think, oh, I could use a bit more, you know, use Mrs. Dash. Already smells a little bit more seasoned, which is nice. I also would think to use like a garlic powder or garlic salt, which I might toss in here in a second, see how it tastes. But it's nice. I mean, whatever you kind of think tastes good. If you want a little bit more oniony, do that. If you want a little bit more garlicky, add more garlic. It's really nice. You can kind of do whatever you like, whatever makes you happy, do it. You start off bland and then just kind of pick it up from there. So garlic, let's throw the rest of the garlic in there. Why not? Like I said, oh, we almost forgot two bay leaves. Put in bay leaves. Make sure you don't eat them later, but bay leaves are essential. They're not essential. They can be added. So put them in there if you have them. Don't go spend $5 on some bay leaves if you don't have them. Not the end of the world. This is my brine chicken. Pretty simple. So you're just gonna take that, get it ready. I guess I could strain it a little bit first, but we'll be fine. Some people, well, a lot of people, will just put a full chicken breast in there or chicken thigh. Chicken thigh is normally the best thing to use for this recipe. I also have chicken breast because it's just what I normally always have around the house. Chicken thigh, though, it's darker, it's juicier, so it's better for this kind of, for a soup. Alright, so because I diced my chicken up, it's probably only going to take about 10 minutes to cook. If you do a full chicken, it's about 20, so I'm going to go between 10 to 15 and check on it. So now we've got time to start cooking our noodles. The noodles take about 6 to 8 minutes, depending how you want them. El dente, it can be called. The smell in the entire house, it's percolating. So if date night's coming over to you, then you know what? She's gonna be very excited the second she walks in the door and just bang, hit with some taste in her nostrils. Nostril taste, we'll call them. So I've poured in the noodles, got the water boiling, and it's all set there, gotten the noodles in there. We're about 10 minutes here, so I'm gonna check the chicken as well. But with the noodles, I like to put in just like a dash. I guess it's not a dash since it's liquid, but it's a little bit of olive oil so they don't stick together, as well as some salt to taste. So we're gonna put some salt in there, get it back to a boil. As mentioned, these take about 6 to 8 minutes to get going, or just refer to your packaging. So we're gonna get those going. Now, as that's heating up, I'm gonna check the chicken, because you don't wanna overcook the chicken, and because I diced it before I cooked it, that definitely could happen. A lot of people will put in the full chicken in there for 20 minutes and cook it in there, which is a great idea. I just try and do it a little bit quicker, dice it up, cooks faster, and because after all, this is the efficient kitchen. Try and make most meals under 30 minutes, and that's the goal. So let's check it out here. I'm gonna grab a piece of chicken. And I diced some so finely that they should just cook very quickly as I burn my finger. Let's check it out. Yeah, I mean, no pink inside. Took about 10 minutes and we're all set. All right, so our noodles are done. The soup is just a nice little boil. It's at a nice slow rolling boil. And now we're gonna strain the noodles. Strain them in there. Don't burn yourself. Drop it like it's hot if you need to. All right. Strain those bad boys up. Now you can keep it separate if you want to, so the noodles don't get all extra soggy when you put it in the fridge afterwards, which I prefer to do. So I'm gonna keep the noodles separate and just do it by the bowl. So I've got my bowl here. Oh, ding, ding, ding. On the money, we're all set. So I've got my bowl here. I am going to get a scoop of noodles, however much I feel like. One, two. Now we're gonna dig in here. Honestly, it smells so good. I can't wait for you to make it. Hopefully you make it for someone special. Maybe it's the first time you guys hold hands or cuddle, watch a little Notebook on the couch. You know, it's kind of starting that relationship off with this beautiful bowl of chicken noodle soup. So I'm excited. You're gonna be excited. Everyone, make sure you try it. This is that chicken noodle soup people die for. Homemade, happiness, everyone's happy. Happiness, said it twice. All right, thanks for coming. First show, it only took about an hour and a half to do. Maybe 2 hours, maybe three, I don't know. But we made it, we did it. Hopefully everyone loves the food. I'm excited. All right, talk to you later. I know I moved. Talk to you later. All right, bye guys.